Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are here with Essence Magazine Editor-at-Large, Mickey Taylor, and she is joining us at the table. Welcome back to the table.
Thank you so much.
Yes. Nice to be at the table with you.
Yes. The legendary.
Yes, she is. So your new book, of course, Editor-in-Chief, is really about empowering women, which you just spoke about, and being the best version of ourselves. So there are a lot of things called Mickey-isms in this book. So we're going to run down a couple of your Mickey-isms. All right. So when you know your value, you won't waste time auditioning for others' approval.
Ooh, that's a good one right there.
Break that down, Ms. Taylor.
You know, it's not about outside validation. You should know who you are, and your life should demonstrate that you know. Yes. You know, I just really believe that when the Creator signed off on us, He was satisfied. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you got to own your story.
Yes.
You got to embrace the cost as well as the delight of being yourself. You don't fit in with everybody. And so... You weren't designed to fit in.
Yes.
You better transform, not conform.
Yes.
So, no. And if that's... You know, and if you need to train yourself for that, go where you're celebrated. Not where you're tolerated.
Yes.
How about that?
Yes.
How about that? Yes. You need some training for that. Just do it that way.
Can you say that last one?
Yes.
Go where you're what?
Go where you're celebrated.
And not what?
Not where you're tolerated.
Come on, man. Yes.
Right. That's not your stop. Don't get on church.
Yeah.
That's not your
stop.
Now let's just keep it on moving.
Yes.
Come on, keep turning up. You say you should identify and harness your purpose. Why is that important?
That's good too.
You have to know what you came to do. Life is not a dress rehearsal. What is that thing that burns inside you, that passion, and that thing that you do so well nobody else can do it like you?
Mm-hmm.
You need to own that. Mm-hmm. And furthermore, you need to visualize how it will serve others.
Mm-hmm.
Your divine assignment was created for you to serve an empire.
Yes, right.
So don't call yourself a queen if you ain't got no queendom.
Hello, somebody.
Oh, my God.
Come on now. About service all the time.
Yeah.
It's so good to hear
someone
that has been in the industry, you know, the way you have and has had such an impact to really confirm that your purpose, you're harnessing your purpose. My God.
Yes, ma'am.
Well,
that's critical.
Look at God.
I got another good one.
Come on, Ms. Scott.
I'd like to share this with the people.
Okay.
She says, which is great advice here, she said, master brand you and be the entrepreneur of your destiny.
Yes.
You got to recognize that you are a brand.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's interesting. I never hired anybody who wanted a job.
Mm-hmm.
I hired people who came to contribute.
Yes.
And I like to link arms and names with people that know who they are and what they contribute.
Yes.
They walk in the door knowing their value and how it's going to work.
Yes.
So, yeah, even for corporate women, when I counsel corporate women, it's like you got to know you're a brand within a brand.
Yes,
you can't be just about brand them growing and brand you is not going anywhere.
Yes, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you got to... You gotta do that.
You gotta be clear.
And I love your.
And it's
your word, your. Mm-hmm.
That's right. So Matt, look at it this way. The last chapter of my book is called Master You Inc.
Mm-hmm.
Everything about you should bear your imprint.
Mm-hmm.
Everything in your life should earn its residence.
Yep.
Whether it's the clothes in your closet or the people in your life.
Come on,
brand you. Gotta nurture brand you.
Yes, ma'am.
And I know, Kiana, you're gonna get to your quote, but what is the difference? Because some women say, oh my God, I'm talking about me. What's the difference between being selfish in the positive sense and not ego when you're talking about brand
right.
you?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we struggle with that.
Yes.
In fact, one of my Mickeyisms is like, you know, don't apologize for God. He knew what he was doing. He created you. Just say thank you.
Mm-hmm.
There folks are really bragging on your architect when they do that.
Yes.
So again, know who you are. It's not self-centered. It's self-nurturing. It's self-demonstration. You know, you should wake up every day excited to be you.
Yes.
Unprecedented.
Yes.
You. Unique. You. Yeah, so self-centered, I don't know where you got that talk, but send it back. Dismiss it.
Right.
Yeah,
it's
and
not
why
your
truth. Celebrate me hurt you?
What?
It
right.
doesn't.
Right.
At all.
And
it
shouldn't.
It doesn't hurt those who are comfortable in their skin.
Ooh.
But if they shopping on your lawn, yeah, it's a problem.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
She dropped it.
So here's one that I really like. Embrace your itness. What do you mean by that?
Oh, your itness, your distinction.
Yes, ma'am.
Again, what stands out about you? Again, don't be trying to compare yourself or be like somebody else. Somebody say, I wish I could be like you. No, you don't. You want to be your best self.
Yes, ma'am.
Again, unprecedented, divine inspired, one of a kind, not a copy.
Ooh.
Your itness.
I like this.
Your itness.
Oh, my
Finding
goodness.
Finding your itness and knowing what it is.
Knowing what it is.
Yes. Okay.
You say women should establish a celebration circle. Is that the sister circle?
Yes, yes, oh, my gosh. It can be, but you can have a few good men in there, too.
Yes.
Yes, you can. The bottom line is your greatness was not designed to operate in isolation, so you better get the people around you who want to see you win,
Come on.
You better know the difference. Don't hallucinate. Don't have people in your circle that they're trying to see what you got and how they can get it, and they ain't really about you.
Right.
Yeah.
We celebration just talked circle. About this,
my God. This
morning.
That's right.
Yes. Just said this
you need some ride or dies, or folks you can call at 4 a.m. and say it ain't pretty, and they'll pull you out of your pity party because it's not the party to throw.
Yes.
Oh, how about that?
I don't know what's going to happen after this show.
Right. I have no idea.
I'm going to be a whole different person.
Nikki, if you will, give us three rituals of the modern day queen.
She takes time for self because she knows that before she can serve others, she got to serve herself. She understands that she can't give what she doesn't have, so she doesn't give out of her lack. She knows how to lovingly say no. She doesn't spend more yeses than she can really cash.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Furthermore, she understands who she is, and she teaches others how to treat and honor her by the way her walk is in life.
Wow. Yes, ma'am.
She doesn't spend more yeses
than she can cash.
Than she can cash.
Oh, well, I got a no to say right after the show.
All right,
lovingly.
Lovingly.
Yes.
We thank you so much. And we would not get out of here without you, you know, pitching a really amazing show that could be on your cover soon.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Let's do this.
Make sure you get editor-in-chief. You know, she will teach you how to style and be most empowered in bookstores everywhere.
One more time, everybody,
for Nikki Taylor. And Sister Circle on the next cover.
Yes.